colon versus semicolon. Which one is stronger? Does it even matter? Colons and semicolons both have specific yet limited use in the world of punctuation. Today, you'll be discovering how to correctly use these often misused punctuation marks. Which one is your arch nemesis? Take a few seconds right now to type your answer to that question down in the comments below, and while you're at it, why not subscribe and click on the little bell so that you can get a notification each time I upload a new lesson. Okay, let's start with the colon. The colon introduces, but what does it introduce? Here are a couple of examples. The first sentence says, my favorite color is the favorite of many, colon, pink. The second example says, it is a question we ask ourselves every day, colon, what is for dinner? Notice that when we introduce a question with a colon, we are going to capitalize the first letter of the first word in that question. Now, we don't see this a lot, and quite frankly, we don't see this first example a lot either. But you know how the SAT essay and many pieces of writing students are asked to do tells you to vary your sentence structure? This is one way you can do it, by writing sentences that include colons to introduce something. One more example I want to show you about colons. Probably the most common use for a colon, the one you're probably most familiar with, is using it to introduce a list, such as in this first example. I went to the store and bought the following, colon, eggs, milk, and tea. Now, you wouldn't have to necessarily use a colon to introduce this list, but there's something I want to show you. I went to the store and bought eggs, comma, milk, comma, and tea. Well, here's the same list and basically the same idea. So why did I use a colon here instead of just starting the list? Well, it's because of this, the following. When you use the following or a phrase like the following, you need to have a colon there as kind of a little bit longer break. I went to the store and bought the following, eggs, milk, and tea. If you didn't have a colon there, the reader would just keep on going and the sentence would sound like this. I went to the store and bought the following, eggs, milk, and tea, and that would not sound right at all because following and eggs would be way too scrunched together. So again, this is a chance for you to vary your sentence structure. Consider, instead of just writing a simple list in a sentence that's not introduced, introducing it with a phrase like the following and using a colon. So we've seen three different uses for the colon. Let's take a look at the semicolon. One way to use a semicolon is to separate items in a list when there are commas included throughout that list as well. Let me show you an example. We have traveled to Chicago, comma, Illinois, semicolon, Nashville, comma, Tennessee, semicolon, and Orlando, Florida. Now, had we just said we've traveled to Chicago, Nashville, and Orlando, we wouldn't have needed to separate those places with a semicolon. But because we have also given the state, Nashville, comma, Tennessee, and so on, we need to separate that list with semicolons. Otherwise, you've got Chicago, comma, Illinois, comma, Nashville, comma, Tennessee, comma, and it gets confusing just reading it. The most common use, however, for a semicolon is to join two simple sentences into a compound sentence. How do we do that? Well, here we've got two really short, simple sentences. Elephants cannot jump, rabbits can jump. Now, that sounds kind of choppy and kind of immature as far as the writing goes, but we can join those two with a semicolon in a couple different ways. Elephants cannot jump, semicolon, but, comma, rabbits can jump. Here what I've done is put a semicolon there, taking the place of the period, and then I've added a coordinating conjunction and a comma. Same exact information, but this is a much more sophisticated way of writing it. But we could just skip the whole coordinating conjunction comma idea and simply join the two simple sentences with a semicolon. Elephants cannot jump, rabbits can jump. Well, there you have it. Colons introduce and semicolons join. So, who's the winner here? You are, because now you know how to use colons and semicolons.